Hi everyone, and welcome back to Stamp with Anna. And today is January 1st, 2018. So first of all, I would like to wish you all a very happy new year, and I send you best wishes for a wonderful 2018. Being the first of the month, this is the Blogging Friends Blog Hop Day, and we are a group of Stampin' Up! Demonstrators from around the country. And every first of the month, we have a blog hop. And this month's theme was Baby It's Cold Outside. And I live in Massachusetts, so it is really, really cold outside. So this month's theme really resonated with me. So for my project, I am making this thank you card for my mother's caregiver. She's always so sweet to my mom, not only around the holidays, but every day. And she gave me a lovely gift for Christmas, so I made this card for her as a thank you. And the set that I went with, the bundle that I went with, is the Smitten Mitten bundle. And now I know I've used that a lot this winter season, which just tells me that I really, really like the stamp set, this bundle, because I just keep finding myself using it, going for it. So this is the stamp set, and it is being continued. It's not being discontinued when the holiday catalog expires in a couple days. This one is carrying over at least through, I believe, when the new catalog comes out in June. When the new catalog comes out, it might not be there, but at least it's going to be available through then. So this is the stamp set, and it has lots of great stamps, large mittens, small mittens, decorations for the mittens, stitching, and it's just awesome. But today, all we're going to use as far as the stamp is these X's right there. And these are the dies that come with it. These will cut out the decorations for the that go on the mitten. These three, as well as this ribbing, this additional ribbing, they simply emboss. They do not die cut out. And then you have the dies for the small mittens and the large mittens, which we'll be using, and a snowflake die. And it's just great. So I hope you agree. Hopefully by the time I'm done with this card, you will agree with me. And to make the hat, I'm also using the largest oval from the layering ovals to make the cable for my mittens and my hat. I am using the dynamic embossing folder called Cable Knit. And the thank you comes from one of my favorite sentiment stamp sets, Teeny Tiny Wishes. These sentiments are so small, they are perfect to tuck into a little spot on your card. As for paper, our base is Pink Pirouette. It's 5.5 by 8.5, scored at 4.25. Then the middle matte piece is Whisper White, and this is 5 1/8 by 3 7/8. And then our card front is Soft Sky, and this is 3 3/4 by 5. And then we do need some scrap Pink Pirouette to cut out our hat and mittens. All of our white pieces that we'll be cutting out, the ribbing for the mittens, the pom-pom for the hat, and the snowflake, and the ribbing on the hat will all be die cut from the inside of our matting piece here. So the first thing we're going to do is take care of all of our white cutting. So what I'm going to do, I need 4 of these. This is the die that cuts out that ribbing right there. And this piece simply embosses the lines in it. Now, I don't know if you can see, I used some Wincastella to give it a little bit of sparkle. So I am going to die cut 4 of those from this inside piece of paper. Then I am also going to die cut the snowflake, and then using the brand new 1 1/8 scallop circle. This is going to be in the occasions catalog, which goes live in 2 days on January 3rd. I'm going to use that and punch out my pom-pom. So I'm going to do all that die cutting, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back with all of my pieces die cut, and here is my white piece of paper that I will be using as a mat. Looks like Swiss cheese. So before I go any further, I am going to just run some Wink of Stella on all of these pieces because I want a little bit of shimmer on my project. And I know you really can't see it on camera, but it really does shine nicely. I'm going to try to bring it up so you can see that. I'm going to do that with all of these pieces. Okay, all of my pieces have been Wink of Stella'd. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my snail and I am going to attach this cut up piece of white onto my card front. I'm going to center that in. I'm going to put that aside. Now I need to make my hat and my mittens. So for that, I'm going to cut out the largest oval shape from the layering ovals thinlets, and I'm going to cut out these two mittens. I'll be right back. Okay, my pieces are die cut, and now I'm going to run them through my embossing folder. Now this embossing folder is a dynamic embossing folder, which means that the impression is very, very deep. So your sandwich is different. Instead of putting an acrylic plate on the bottom and on the top, you only use an acrylic plate on the top. So your sandwich is your platform, your embossing folder with your paper inside, and then an acrylic plate, and you run it through. Now, when I place my oval and my mittens in this folder, I want to be careful about how I place them. See here, I have the cable knits on my hat going vertically, but I have them going horizontally on my mittens. And I did that on purpose because I liked the mittens horizontal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place my oval, which is my hat, up here. And then I'm going to place my two mittens this way. I want to make sure that I have them lined up next to each other so that their patterns are the same. So now I'm going to go run these through the Big Shot. I'll be right back. Okay, and everything is put together. Now I just need to attach my ribbing. So how I'm going to do that is I'm going to put a little bit of snail on the back of the ribbing and put it on the top of each of my mittens. So now my mittens are done. And to do my hat, I'm going to line these up. I'm going to overlap them like this, and then I'm going to trim it away. So you'll see what I mean in just a second. I'm going to line this up here because I want to kind of keep the shape of the hat. I don't want the hat to look like an oval. And I'm going to attach that right there. And I'm going to come in with my snips. And I'm going to trim away the bottom part here. And I'm going to move this over just a tiny bit. And that is how I made the shape of my hat. Now what I'm going to do is attach my pom-pom to the top of the hat, and I'm going to use a glue dot for the snowflake. And I'm going to put that right over here to hide my seam. Now what I also want to do with my pink pirouette ink and a sponge dauber is I want to just lightly highlight the outline of all of the pink parts of this because I want them to stand out when I place them against each other. I don't want the pinks to blend into each other. I'm just kind of like outlining it. And it's a very, very faint, you're not rubbing it in, you're just tapping along the edges of it. And you can see that it gives it a little bit of a outline. So now I'm going to put all of these aside. And we're going to do the little stamping that we have to do. So on the soft suede, I'm going to take the thank you. And I'm going to stamp that up in this top right corner. Then I'm going to take the stitching. And I'm going to stamp that along the bottom here. In probably about an inch from the left side. Now I'm going to sprinkle that with some white embossing powder. Okay, looks good. And I'm going to heat that up with my heat tool. Okay, that's all embossed, and now I'm just going to attach this to my card. And when I attach it, I make sure my thank you is up in the top right. And you can never tell that we used that white matte piece to punch out and die cut all of our elements. Okay, so now we just need to attach our hat and gloves and mittens to our project. So I'm going to use some snail. I'm going to put a lot on because the embossing is deep. So I'm going to make sure that I have enough adhesive on it so that it doesn't go anywhere. And I'm going to do this mitten first. I'm going to offset my mitten just a little bit right here. And this one right here. Now, I want to strategically place these because I'm going to come in with some pearls. I have to come in and take some little tiny pearls here. And I'm going to put three along this side because three is about what fits. And straighten them up. And, and I'm going to put two sticking out right there. And then I'm going to put a larger one in the middle of my snowflake. And there we have it. Our card is complete. And I think it's a nice project to have for a winter card. And I hope you can see the Wink of Stella on that because it really does add a nice little shimmer to it. There we go. Thank you, card. And this, like I said, the theme was Baby, It's Cold Outside. And this certainly says it's cold. So I encourage you to hop on over to my blog. And I will put a direct link in the description below. And from there, you can hop on to the rest of the blogs that are participating in the blog hop this month. And if you do not have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator with whom you work and you would like to receive a occasions catalog with the celebration catalog, which has all of the free items you can earn, certainly contact me either through my blog, through the right here on YouTube up at the top of my banner. There's a little icon that says 123. If you click on that, that will take you to a contact form. Or if you're watching this through my Facebook, there is a contact button off to the left. My blog is www.stampwithanna.blogspot.com. I hope you've enjoyed this project, and I will see you again on Wednesday. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.